need to hurry, no need to worry. Mr. Bluebird, how you do? Let the sunshine fill your heart with joy. Boys and girls, come out to play. Don't sit and ponder, look over yonder. Here come those lazy days.
Right, here we are. You feeling better, Trevor?
Sorry, Dad, but you know how I hate long car journeys.
Oh, come on, Trevor, it was only 9 miles. And all the windows open, stopped 4 times. Anyway, there's something here I want to show you. Look there, see?
Yeah, I know. It's blue, isn't it?
The sea? What else can you see out there?
Sand?
Oh, it's true.
Look! There! Oh, you mean the pier.
Exactly.
Can we go on it?
No, it's closed.
Oh, what time's it open then?
It doesn't. It's closed permanently, has been since 1932.
Oh, I see. Well, why have we come all the way over here just to have a look at an old pier?
Allow me to explain, Trevor. That pier is owned by Midbourne Council, and they have just put it up for sale.
Cool. Hey, where are they going to find an idiot to buy a thing like that, eh?
You already have, Trevor. Me. Or rather, us.
You're joking.
No, no, no. That pier, Trevor, is part of this country's heritage. And there it lies, closed, rusting, rejected. That's not right.
Yeah, that may be, Dad, but why us? I mean, we don't know anything about running a pier.
Listen, Trevor, did Columbus turn around at King John and say, I don't know anything about fighting armadas? No, of course he didn't. He just jumped on the Mayflower and off he went.
Well, how much they want for it, then?
That's a very reasonable question, eh? The asking price, Trevor, is 5 shillings.
5 bob? Don't be so daft.
No, I promise you. That is all that Midbourne Council want for that prime example of British seaside history.
Blimey.
Naturally, anybody who buys it is going to have to guarantee to spend a certain amount on maintenance for the first 6 months.
How much?
£2,000.
£2,000? Where are we going to get £2,000 from?
Right, all right, Trevor, calm down. Don't want your boil coming up again, do we?
Sorry, Dad. Where are we going to get that sort of money from, eh?
Right, listen. Where did my sister Laura move to a year ago?
Oh, over here to Midbourne.
Right. And who is my sister married to?
Your brother-in-law.
And what does Mr. Richard Talbot do?
He's a bank manager.
Precisely.
Well, how's he gonna help? I mean, you're not exactly mates, are you? You've kind of seen each other for at least 5 years.
Oh, that's very true. Very true, Trevor. All the same, I have a feeling that there's a very good chance that Mr. La-dee-dah Talbot might give us a loan. Or my name is not Ron Archer.
Oh, yes, sir, I agree, Mrs. Reynolds. If your car's done 184,000 miles, it might well be time to change it. Especially if you're going to take up rallying. Right, see you on the 25th. Goodbye. Come in.
It's only me, Mr. Talbot.
Oh, good morning, Miss Baxter. Is that the mail?
Yes, sir. And a list of your appointments for this morning.
Thank you very much. As efficient as ever. Hello. Why is this letter still unopened?
It's special. It's to you, sir, from me, a little card.
Really? It's not my birthday. Oh, how nice. An old sailing ship.
Frigate.
Pardon? Oh, yes. I see what you mean. Happy anniversary. How thoughtful.
Thank you.
What anniversary?
Yours, sir. It was exactly a year ago today that you arrived at Midbourne to take over as manager of this branch.
Good Lord, so it was. Fancy you remembering that.
Oh, I do, sir. You see, it's been absolutely marvellous since you took over from Mr. Russell. I really enjoy coming to work now.
But I'm very glad to hear it, and thank you for the card. Hey, by the way, Miss Baxter, did you manage to telephone Middleton Motors about having my car serviced tomorrow?
Yes, I did, but they said they were fully booked.
Really? Well, phone them back and ask to speak to Mr. Middleton himself.
Very good, sir.
We can look after their account. They can look after my car. You scratch my back and I'll scratch yours. Hey, Miss Baxter.
Oh, Mr. Oh, I see what you mean.
Yes, the appointment, sir. Mr. Harris was coming in first this morning, wasn't he?
Oh, yes, he was, sir, but he's had to cancel it. Something about a sudden bereavement.
Not his own, presumably.
Very dry sense of humour, you know.
Oh, do I?
Just the sort I like a man to have.
Really? Well, anyway, does that mean I don't have a first appointment this morning?
Oh, no, sir. After Mr. Harris cancelled, another gentleman telephoned and asked to see you, so I put him in instead. He's a new customer.
Oh, jolly good.
I think he was arriving as I came in to see you, so shall I send him in?
Yes, please.
Very good, sir. His name's Archer.
Thank you, Miss Baxter. Archer? Not Ron Archer, by any chance. That is Mr. R. Archer. No, it can't be. Miss Baxter, could you do me a favor?
Oh, anything, Mr. Talbot.
Could you just open my door a touch? Have a look at this Mr. Archer and describe him to me.
Oh, all right, Mr. Talbot. Well, I'd say he's... he's about 45.
Oh, it could be him. Yes, go on.
And he's picking his teeth with one of our leaflets.
That's it. It must be him.
Are you all right, Mr. Talbot? You've gone quite pale.
Could you open a window, please, Miss Baxter?
You're not going to do anything silly, are you?
Sorry? No, of course not.
Oh, good, because we're only on the ground floor. You think you know the gentleman?
What? Yes, possibly. Anyway, you better show him in.
Very good, sir. Would you come in, Mr. Archer?
Oh, Tara, thank you.
Mr. Archer, sir.
Hello, Dickie. Long time no see.
There it is.
Is this your office, then?
Yes, of course it is.
Nice.
Now, look, Ron, what exactly,
Well, don't you usually ask your customers to sit down?
What's that? Hmm? Won't you sit down?
Oh, that's very kind of you, thank you. Well, then, how's Laura, my big sister?
Yeah, she's still pretty large. She's fine.
Oh, great.
How are you?
Oh! Rubbing along, you know.
Oh, jolly good. any news of your wife?
No, not yet, but she'll be back. It's only a question of time.
How long is it now then, since you ran away with that publican fellow?
18 years.
how is your son,
Trevor? He's okay. He's working at our local Woolies.
Oh, good.
Yeah, it seems funny, doesn't it? I mean, the two of us sitting here, chatting away happily. You know, I mean, you, an important bank manager, me, just an ordinary, everyday sort of a bloke. The two of us brought together by the sanity of marriage.
Sanctity.
Oh, yes, that's right, yes. I mean, although we're brother-in-laws...
Brothers-in-law.
Yes, that's right, yes. But we haven't got much in common, have we?
I think you've got much more in common than I have.
Yes, well, anyway, the thing is, I am thinking of starting a little business venture over here in Midbourne, and I want to open a bank account over here.
I see. Well, there's Lloyd's in the High Street, Barclays on the...
No. I want to open it here. With you. You know what I mean? Keep it in the family instead of in the post office.
Yes, well, I see. All right. What sort of amount are we talking about?
Well, I have applied to cash in these savings certificates. That's £4.70.09.
Well, that'll certainly put the bank back in its feet.
And then this is my post office savings book. Now, I put a bid in here for Trevor's education, you know, university and that sort of thing.
And you've never used it?
No, well, the war put paid to all that, didn't it? And then again, Trevor went off the idea of being a brain surgeon.
So how much is in that?
There's £96.14.08.
Oh, well, that's a bit better.
Yes, and then there's this 50 quid that I got for offloading 1,000 tins of government surplus snook. Listen, you wouldn't like a few tins, would you, Dickie?
There's me.
What?
Thank you.
Oh, all right.
So let me see, altogether that makes, five, carry one.
Yes, it's £151.12.05.
What? Exactly right.
Yes. Well, I should be getting the post office warrants any day now.
Oh, well, come and see me then.
No. I haven't finished yet. You see, I want a loan.
A loan?
Yeah.
But you haven't even opened your account yet.
Yes, well, I know that. But, I mean, there is so much at stake, Dickie. I mean, this whole venture depends on you.
Well, it's most unorthodox, but I suppose there's no harm in taking a few details.
Good.
Purpose of loan.
We want to buy Midbourne Pier.
Wishes to buy Midbourne. Oh, sorry. Did you say you wanted to buy the pier?
Yes, me and Trevor, yes.
Don't be so ridiculous.
Well, he only want £5 for it.
Well, surely you don't need to borrow £5.
Well, of course I don't know, but once having bought it, you then have to guarantee to spend a certain amount in maintenance.
I don't understand this at all.
Huh?
The pier's closed, isn't it? Has been for several years.
Well, that's right, yeah.
And the middle bit's missing, isn't it?
Well, we can put that back.
But why? Why?
Well, if you don't put it back, you won't be able to get to the end bit.
No, I mean, why do you want to buy a broken-down old pier?
Listen, that pier is part of this country's heritage. And if somebody doesn't buy it soon, the council's going to demolish it. It'll finish up as a heap of rubble and twisted metal.
It's not far from that now.
Oh, now, listen.
I'd like to help.
Oh, good.
But head office would come down on me like a ton of bricks.
Oh, I see. Oh, well, I had hoped that I wasn't going to have to mention this, but, at our local Odeon, there's an usherette called Mandy. Now, she's told me some very interesting things about you, Dickie.
I don't know anyone called Mandy.
Oh, well, perhaps Mandy's surname might mean something to you, then.
Possibly. What is it?
Smith. Now, does that ring a bell?
Well, several, actually. There's Charles Smith at the golf course. There's Albert Smith.
No. I'm talking about a Lady Smith.
The only Lady Smith I know is the one that got relieved.
No. I'm talking about a female Smith. Mandy's mum, to be precise. Gloria Smith. I believe she got relieved, in a manner of speaking.
That Smith.
Yes.
Charming woman.
Yes, I believe. Yes, it was when you first came over here to Midbourne, wasn't it?
Yes, that's right. I needed somewhere to stay until I could find a place for Laura and the children to join me, so I answered her advert.
Yes, and her prayers, by all accounts, her being a lonely widow.
It is only for the first month. Anyway, there was nothing in it.
Oh, I see. So there's nothing that you wouldn't want Laura to find out about, then?
Well...
Yes, I must say, she is a big girl, my sister, isn't she? And you know what they say, don't you, Dickie? Hell hath no fury like a woman scorned.
Yes.
And of course, all that scandal wouldn't help your relationship with head office, would it now? On top of all that funny business, a few years back when all those travellers' checks lost their sense of direction.
How do you know about that?
Well, let's just say that Gloria can't keep a secret and neither can her daughter. And if I get upset, Dickie, my tongue can wag like a terrier's tail.
On reflection, I think I might be able to grant you a loan, everything being equal.
Oh, good. Well, Trevor and me have got an appointment with the town clerk on Thursday. We'll see you there, 11:30.
Well, look, I just think I could
possibly... Mandy also told me that her mum had mentioned...
11:30, I'll be fine.
Nearly 22 now. I don't suppose they've forgotten about us, do you?
Perhaps they've just decided to demolish the pier after all.
Do you know what you're saying? That pier was built in 1860 by Eugenius Birch.
Who?
Eugenius Birch is one of the greatest pier designers ever. Brighton, Eastbourne, Margate, they're all his.
Really? I'd no idea.
The town clerk will see you now, Mr. Archer.
Oh, tar very much, yeah.
Thank you.
After you.
Oh, all right.
Mr. Ron Archer and Mr. Trevor Archer.
Oh, come in, gentlemen. Morning to you.
Morning to you, sir.
My name's Cummings. I'm the town clerk and... Oh, hello, Richard.
Morning, Henry.
What on earth are you doing here?
Oh, he is our financial advisor.
Is he? Am I?
Well, anyway, take a seat, gentlemen. May I introduce Mr. Rawlings? He's our entertainment manager.
Oh. Hello, Derek. You're looking well.
Thank you, Richard. Nice to see you.
And Mr. Winters, our head of publicity.
Morning, Graham. How's Libby?
Fine, thank you, Richard. And Laura?
Blooming as usual.
And last but not least, Mr. Short, the borough treasurer.
Yes, of course. How are you, Frank? How are your geraniums this year?
They're doing marvellously, Richard. And you should see my hibiscus.
Bigger than ever, eh?
Enormous. It's the leaf mold.
Excuse me, I hate to interrupt this fascinating horticultural discussion, but do you think we can get on with the matter in hand, sir?
Ah, good idea. Now, Mr. Archer, you realise that the pier needs a good bit doing to it.
Oh, yes, indeed, yes, but that pier must be saved. It's an historical monument.
That's right. It was built in 1066 by Ignoramus Birch.
Eugenius Birch.
Oh, yeah, well... He had hands in it as well.
Yes, yes. Well, we realise there's a lot of hard work to be done, but that pier could be a real asset to this town. Sticks out a mile.
A quarter of a mile, actually.
Oh, that's very funny. Did you hear that, Mr. Archer?
What?
You said it sticks out a mile, and then Richard said a quarter of a mile.
Tell me, Mr. Archer, what sort of plans do you have for the pier?
Of course, the first thing we've got to do is put back the missing bit.
Otherwise, nobody will be able to go to the theatre.
Ah.
Now, what ideas have you for the theatre?
Many and varied.
Well, it's very small, you know.
We could try and get hold of wee Georgie Wood.
Look, as borough treasurer, I think perhaps I should be talking to you about finance.
Oh, well, in that case, can I hand you over to my financial advisor, Mr. Talbot?
What?
Fire away.
Well, Richard, as you know, there are some conditions attached to the sale of the pier in respect of maintenance.
Yes, Mr. Archer did mention that.
Perhaps you'd like to have a look at them.
Thank you.
Yeah. What other ideas have you got for the pier, Mr. Archer?
boat trips, you know, trips around the lighthouse, that sort of thing.
We haven't got a lighthouse.
Oh, well, if you ever decide to build one, we'll be ready, won't we? Yes, and I think we should reinstate Madame Zara, the gypsy fortune teller, if she's still around.
Yeah, she works for the council, in forward planning.
Oh.
Is there something not quite clear, Richard?
There are a couple of small points I'd like to discuss with Mr. Archer, if he could have a few moments together. Alone.
I'll tell you what, the four of us will pop next door and set up a little tipple to cement the occasion, eh? Right, what'll it be, Henry?
Gin and tonic, if I may.
Oh, yeah, I'll have the same.
Right, and what about you, young man?
Have you got any orange?
You want a gin and orange?
No, just orange.
Right. Well, away we go, gentlemen. I do hope we have a lemon.
Well, there's a lemon here, all right.
What's the matter, Dickie? Something up?
Yes, my blood pressure. You never told me just how much you had to guarantee to spend on the pier. Just how much you expected my bank to lend you.
Well,
Well, you never asked.
Clothes and bones.
That's right, $2,000 every 6 months for the first 3 years.
What? Where does it say that?
It's in the Gazette. It must be in there somewhere.
But that's out of the question. Anyway, a manager would have to consult the bank's directors before he could lend a person that sort of money.
Ah, yes, but I am not a person, am I, Dickie? Now, supposing I was 10 different people, 9 of them fictitious.
What?
You know what I mean?
Don't be so ridiculous.
What?
That's quite impossible.
Oh, is it? All right, Trevor, would you ask Mr. Cummins and his friends to come back in here, please?
Yes, Dad.
Just a minute, Ron.
Just a minute, Trevor.
What exactly are you going to say to them?
Well, just that you don't feel that your bank is able to support me financially. Yes, off you go, Trevor.
Right, Dad.
Yes?
Well, yes, a few other things.
Wait, just a minute, Ron.
Just a minute, Trevor.
What sort of other thing?
Well, for starters, the fact that the reason my wife left me 18 years ago was because she couldn't stand the disgrace of having had an affair with her brother-in-law.
What?
Yeah. And that she left me all alone to bring up Trevor, who's the fruit of your labours, so to speak.
But none of that's true.
Well, I know that, and you know that. But they don't.
But they're not fools. No one would believe a story like that.
Yes, they'll believe me all right, especially when they hear about Gloria and all those travellers' checks that suddenly decided to stop at home. And what about all those nice little backhanders you get from the town and around building society? Yeah. Yes, they'll believe me all right, and so will your posh Masonic friends. You'll be out of that lot before you've got a chance to unroll your trouser leg. Yeah, look at that. You know, when you two smile, the resemblance is quite uncanny.
10 different people, you say?
That's right. £200 apiece is not much, is it?
It'll take a lot of organising.
Here we are, then. All settled, is it?
Well,
all settled.
Jolly good.
There have been several people after the pier, so to avoid too much delay, the legal boys have already drawn up the necessary documents.
Oh, that is very efficient.
Or put it another way, hurry up and sign this before the pier falls over.
Let's see. Richard, you're probably the most disinterested party here. Perhaps you'd like to sign this.
Yes, of course.
Oh, well, grab your glasses, gentlemen. Oh. Are you all right, young man?
No. I've got a nose bleed.
Then you let come on.
Just now, a UK bed.
Excitement, I expect. Gentlemen, I give you a toast to the new owners of Midbourne Pier.
The new owners of Midbourne Pier.
All 10 of them.
Lazy days will soon be here again. Cares and troubles, toodaloo. No need to hurry, no need to...